Good afternoon, students. Welcome to this English class. So we are in the process of revising. You remember on Friday we finished our entire syllabus, and on Saturday we discussed the question paper model in detail. So we promised that from today onwards we will revise the units. 8, 9 and 10 we had done with you during the lockdown. So we will do 6 and 7. Okay, so we will thoroughly do that because that was done for your first internal. So we will take you through unit 6 and 7 during these days so that you will be completely ready for your examination. And congratulations all second years on being promoted without writing an exam to your third year. But don't lax, keep on do your preparation and keep it away, and then enjoy your summer holidays. So today we are going to do unit 6. We are revising. We are starting our revision. The poem is The Flower by Alfred Tennyson. I'm going to give you a brief introduction to Alfred Tennyson and the poem, okay, so that you recollect, because it was done in the month of January maybe, so you must have forgotten. So quickly recapping it for you, and then we will go on to do the poem in detail and then the question answer. So, the Flower by Alfred Tennyson. Alfred Tennyson, 1809 to 1892, was one of the most renowned poets and an embodiment of the Victorian age. He succeeded William Wordsworth as the poet laureate of England and held the position from 1850 till his death in 1892. You must remember that Alfred Tennyson was also a romantic poet. He belonged to the romantic age like William Wordsworth. Although as an official poetic person, he often felt obliged to celebrate the rise of the industrial and the mercantile England during the 19th century, he identified himself more with rural England and its natural beauty. You see the dichotomy in Tennyson's poem, because he is the go between the romantic and the Victorian age. Okay, so he had what do you call the elements of the romantic age deeply embedded in him, and he was also transiting into the Victorian age, which is celebrated by the great industrial revolution and the mercantile expedition that was happening during Queen Victoria's age. So you see this kind of the poet being torn by his love for nature and then the industrial and the mercantile development that was happening in 19th century England. He identified himself more with rural England, but then because he was the poet laureate and the voice of England, he does celebrate industrial revolution and mercantile England, the voyages, the conquests, the empire building that was happening in Victorian England also. His poetry is characterized by beautiful lyricism and a sense of sound and rhythm. Some of his very important poems are The Lotus Eaters, Ulysses, and In Memoriam. If you get time, now that you are in lockdown, maybe you could Google search these poems and read it. Now, let me briefly give you a brief introduction to the poem before we have a detailed summary of the poem. The poem, The Flower, was published in 1864. And it is part of the volume called The Flowers. It is part of a volume of flowers, and it's a delightful small poem. And Tennyson very fondly call it my little fable. Little fable means my little moral story, okay? The poem is a very wry meaning a dry comment on how people react to something new and original. So when you are, talking about, when you see something new, your reaction is very, very different. For example, COVID-19, it is something new. And we, most of us in the beginning couldn't believe that we would see death on such a massive case, okay? People are unsure and apprehensive, and they reject what is not familiar as worthless and harmful. But they are also curious and envious, and they want to appropriate or take over what is new. After a while, when the new is widely adopted and assimilated into our way of life, it loses its uniqueness and novelty and becomes commonplace. Once again, the people lose interest in it and abandon it as useless. So the poem, what Tennyson is suggesting through the poem is that we should have the courage and the conviction, and we should act according to our belief and be unmindful of praise or criticism. The new idea that the poem that is referring to is not clear. What exactly is the poet referring to? Okay, that is not clear. He uses the flower as a powerful symbol. Different writers, critics have interpreted the flower as representing different things. Some say that it refers to the Industrial Revolution. Some says it refers to Christianity, because you remember it's in the 19th century that the Darwin's theory of evolution came about, and that was in direct contradiction to the way of looking at how the human race came into existence. And some also say that maybe it is Tennyson's own poetry and he had a lot of imitators, so maybe he was talking about that. But what remains important, or what is important to us, is it's a beautiful small poem that conveys the central idea that people are very not open to adopting or adapting something new, and then when they do it, then after some time they reject it as commonplace. Okay, so that's the central idea of the poem. And let's go through the poem, The Flower by Tennyson, and it will become clear for you. Okay?
Now we'll just, because we have already done this poem in our classes, we'll just look at it and try to answer some short questions. Then after this, then we'll have a summing up of the whole poem, right? So the first question that we are going to deal is, what did the people call the flower at first? What did they call the flower at first? So the answer to this will be that the speaker in the poem, once in a golden hour, sowed a seed. Soon the seed grew into a plant. In a few days, a flower appeared there. People saw the flower and they called it weed. The very beautifully through this flower, he's trying to say that when anything new comes, people reject it. So in the similar manner, when a new flower has come out, they did not appreciate the beauty of the flower, but they called it weed. Now the second question is, how did they react when they saw it in the garden? What was their reaction? Now, Tennyson's poem, The Flower, spreads its perfume all around, right? Now, people saw the flower in the speaker's garden and they did not see its beauty. They were very unhappy with it. They cursed the flower and the speaker. That was their reaction, and they called the flower as a weed, right? Next, the third question is, did people's curses have any effect on the growth of the flower, right? Now, when people started cursing this, remember the poem is indirectly where the poet is trying to say that through the poem, through fabulous, through something, he is trying to give us a bigger meaning. Through the poem, the poet is trying to tell that when anything new comes, people reject it. For example, when computers in the beginning had come, everybody rejected it, right? They cursed it. But today, we all cannot live even one day without the computer. So the third question is, did the people's curse have any effect on the growth of the flower? Now, the people failed to see the merit in the flower and in the speaker's garden. So they cursed the flower. But their curses had no effect on the flower. It grew taller and it grew brighter. So also the poet says, anything good, if people try to say bad about it, or if they try to curse it also, it will not have any effect. And on the other hand, the good will show its true colors, right? The fourth question is, what happened when the plant grew tall, right? So a plant grew in the speaker's garden and a flower blossomed on it. The flower soon turned into tall and brilliant one with light as its crown, right? So it turned out to become a very beautiful flower, and tempted by its beauty and tempted by its richness, thieves stole it overnight. So they stole it overnight. So in the similar manner, as I gave you an example, in the beginning when computers came, people shunned away from computers. But overnight what happened? People got addicted to computers. So that is what this answer is. The next fifth one is, this additional information you can give it in the conclusion in your answer. The fifth one is, what did the thieves do with the stolen seeds? Right? What did the thieves do with the stolen seeds? Now, the speaker's garden had a plant with colorful flowers. Initially, they cursed it, but later on, when the flowers turned out to become beautiful, one night, some thieves stole its seeds and then they sowed them far and wide. They sowed them in their gardens far and wide. Thus, the flower soon grew everywhere. Earlier, it was only in the speaker's garden, but once they saw the beautiful flower and the beauty of the richness of the flower, everybody stole that flower and they sowed it in their gardens too, and so it was grown everywhere. The sixth question, how did the people react when the flower grew everywhere? Now, how did they react? Now, what was their reaction later when it grew everywhere? Now, the thieves spread the seeds all over, right? The flower from the speaker's garden reached everywhere, right? So people saw the flowers now at every place and they started saying, splendid is the flower in the beginning. They said it was just a weed, but later on they said that it was a splendid flower, right? The seventh question is, what happened to the quality and beauty of the flower when the seed was cast everywhere? Now, when something is rare, you know, we try to appreciate it. But once it becomes common, what is the reaction of the people? So that is what the poet is trying to ask in this question. So the flower describes human nature in great detail. Thieves stole the seed from the speaker's garden, sowed it everywhere. As a result, most people got a chance to raise the flower. But only some people were able to grow really pretty flowers. Many others were growing flowers of poor quality. What will happen? If everybody start doing it, then imitation start coming out. So, and then the quality of the real flower goes down. The value also goes down. Same case with computers. Now you have assembled computers, China-made computers, all that. So the quality deteriorates when the production is more and more of the same kind. So that is what he says. Initially, now this is the nature of human being. Initially, when something new comes, we reject it. But later on, when we find that it is interesting, we try to have it. And when the want is more than the supply, when the supply is more than the want, then slowly its quality starts reducing, right? And the last question is, how did the people view the flower when it became commonplace? So, but this is a poem where the various turns, the poet is trying to show the various turns in people's attitudes, right? Initially, they disliked it. Then later on, they appreciated the beauty. They stole that, they grew it. But again, when it became common, people started cursing it again. So, the speaker's garden has worthless. Later, they accepted it, grew it everywhere. And then when it was seen everywhere, people again termed it that it is just a weed. So they came back to the same place where they began with, right? So these are the strange ways of human mentality. Human behavior is such, where he tries to say that initially they don't want a change. And when they later on know the benefits of the change, they will accept it. And when the change become common, again, they will try to curse it. This is the nature of the people. So this is all how the questions are answered. Now, Bangla ma'am will sum up the whole poem for you. Thank you.
Bangla, just do the glossary also, ma'am.
Glossary, I don't have that. I'll just sum up the poem.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you want me to do the...
I'll do the glossary if you want quickly.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Students, the glossary for you of this poem. Cast, to throw something. Weed, an undesirable plant that grows and spreads fast among cultivated plants, depriving them of space and food. The next word is to and fro. It's a phrase, backward and forward, back and forth. Through, in the contracted form, meaning through. Bower. Bower is a shaded place under the branches of a tree in a garden. Mutter, to speak in a low tone. The next word is discontent. Discontent is unhappiness or dissatisfaction. The next word is curse. Curse is to swear. Okay? And the next word in the glossary is sow. Sow is to put seeds in the ground. The next word in your glossary is splendid. Splendid means brilliant, very good, or very beautiful. Fable. The poem is the fable, a short moral story. And a phrase you have, the last one, he that run may read. It's a phrase from the Bible, which means that something has been written or explained so clearly that anyone, even a non-expert, can understand it easily. He that run may read. It's a phrase from the Bible. It means something that's written or explained so clearly that even a non-expert can understand clearly. Those were the words from the poem. Okay,
I'll give you a quick summary. So what happened in the poem initially? Tennyson, in a golden hour, he sowed a seed. That seed grew into a plant with a beautiful flower. Initially, people thought it was a weed. They muttered, they cursed the writer, what kind of seeds he's sowing in his garden, all waste of time, energy and all that. After a few days, the flower became into the weed or the plant turned into a beautiful flower. Now, when it became a seed, people stole it and they sowed it in other places. Soon, it was grown everywhere. And then, some grew attractive, some grew very produced, poor kind of flowers. But then when it became of a common place, they called it a weed. So in the beginning, this sowing a seed and all that, you know, Tennyson is a very good writer. His career expanded for almost 60 years. He started it. He was very famous. And being a celebrity, he was copied by the others and he was imitated. He was parodied. All his works were stolen, lifted, plagiarized. But then he stood as an inspiration to many young writers. So the seed that he sowed here refers to his creative idea. The creative idea or the poems he wrote. That initially people said it is all nonsense, waste of time. But then when it became a beautiful flower and everybody started appreciating it, then people stole. Stealing it is stealing the ideas. Then they used it in their gardens everywhere. So it is the attitude of people. When something new is created, people will criticize. But later, when it gets popular, people will lift it, use it, steal it, and use it according to their needs. And then they curse the original idea. So in a way, Tennyson kind of parodies or gives it in ironically. He says, whatever seed I gave, stupid fellows, you have copied it, you stole it, you're using it, and you're criticizing me. So he kind of puts it in a nutshell, saying that when you believe that something, when we believe in something, we should not change. Even though people might call 101 things, they might call you, they might criticize you, they might say you're just wasting your time. But if you have belief in your ability, just go ahead and don't change. People will praise it, accept, people will blame it, don't bother. So we should do what we should believe in. So it is a kind of an autobiographical note also in his particular poem. Any doubts, any questions? Yes, ma, you can unmute and you can ask if you have any doubts.
They will ask you an essay question on this poem, right? They will also tell you to answer the essay question, what is the central idea of the poem, yeah, right? So you need to discuss on those lines.
What we'll is be giving you the summary by on 30th. We will give you the worked out, we'll give you summary of all the lessons and all the worked out grammar details, right? No, we will be doing that, right? Yeah. Yeah, so you won't have any issues.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can attempt your main questions also, your big questions for 12 marks and all the worked out exercises that are behind the textbook also, we will be giving you, behind each lesson, we will be giving it to you on 30th. So with that, we will close for today. Any questions?
Students, any questions?
Good children.
No.
Okay. We'll meet
so
you tomorrow.
Understood the poem, right? You know what exactly it is. So next time, when anything new comes in your life, don't try to shy away from it or don't shun away from it, right? We should all experiment new things in our life, right? A change should always be accepted. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Yeah. Okay, then tomorrow we will look at the grammar part of it, a quick revision. Till then, stay home, stay safe. If you have any doubts, let us know.
Take care, ma. Take care. See you tomorrow.
Yes, so that you have some time to have your lunch and then go into your next session. So we are winding off a little early because most of the students are saying that it is lunchtime and they are not able to get into other class. So I think we give more importance to your optionals where you have to complete your syllabus. So please have your lunch and please attend those classes too. Bye. Bye. Stay safe. Stay indoors.
So
thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Pardon me.